You have a major source of air leakage connected right to your house, and let me tell you, if you don't seal it up, your house will never be comfortable. Now, you might be thinking that attached garage is going to act as a barrier from any kind of air movement getting into your home, but that's not really how it works. So let's talk about why it's so important to insulate that common garage wall to make your home more comfortable and energy efficient. So before I tell you why you should insulate that garage common wall, let's talk about reasons why people don't. First and foremost, they just don't think it's that big of an issue. They don't think that they need to because the garage is going to block any kind of air movement. But what they're not considering is the fact that that large garage door is actually a big source of air movement into the garage, which then will be into your home. Now, another reason why people don't insulate that wall is just for the cost. In their minds, it's cheaper to just insulate those three exterior walls and just leave the common wall uninsulated. You're blocking air in these three walls, but you still have a huge garage door that is allowing air leakage into the garage and then into the home. Finally, people are concerned about their drywall. Now, the good thing about a product like RetroFoam injection foam is that it can be installed from the inside. They can do the install from inside of the garage. They'll drill the holes, they'll do the cleanup, and that wall will now be air sealed. Some people are just concerned about the amount of drilling. Is it going to permanently damage the wall? Are they going to leave behind a huge mess? And honestly, a good contractor is not going to do that to you. They're going to fill those holes, put a rough patch of mud over top of it, and then whatever that finish needs to be on the wall, that's something to discuss with your contractor, but it's not a huge deal and it doesn't require a huge remodel like traditional options would. Now, I've explained to you why people don't see the value in insulating that garage common wall, but now I'm going to explain to you why it is actually a very valuable place to go ahead and insulate with RetroFoam. First and foremost, I can't say it enough, you want to block those air leaks. If you use a product like RetroFoam, you're creating an air seal in that wall. So essentially, any air that's in that garage, which let's be honest, unless your garage is insulated, it's not the most comfortable space, and it probably tends, depending on the time of year, to either be super cold or super hot, and there is no in between. Whatever that air temperature is, if that wall's not air sealed with something that creates a great air barrier, then you're going to have comfort issues in your home. If you only plan on using an air seal product in three of your walls, and you leave that common wall uninsulated, you're dealing with the same issues that you had before. That air is just finding another way in, which is going to be through the common wall. Now, I have harped on that garage door a lot in this video, and you know what? I'm not sorry. I'm about to do it again. Depending on your garage door habits, do you leave it open all the time? Do you leave it cracked all the time? That is a big source of air movement when you really start to think about it. You wouldn't just leave all of your doors on the ground floor wide open plus your windows. Like, that's a lot of air movement coming in. And then if you happen to be in a home that has more than one garage door and you have those same habits, that's doubling the amount of air that is coming into the garage and then going into your house. You're allowing a lot of air leakage in there, so your best bet's going to be to create an air barrier so all that outside air isn't coming inside. I'm not done, because there's a few more things that you may want to avoid in your home, such as fumes from your garage. Do you start the car in the wintertime to warm it up? That car, even if you have your garage door open, which is a smart thing to do because of, you know, the fumes from the car, but that's a whole other video. If your car is running, sure, that exhaust fume can go out through the garage door, but it's also going to come into your home because there's nothing blocking it as far as an air barrier. Another great thing that foam insulation does is it also has sound dampening qualities. Now, I'm not saying that's a reason why you should buy it, but it definitely comes in handy if your garage also happens to be your workshop. Tools, car work, anything like that, it can get really noisy. It's not a reason to buy it, but it is an added benefit that it can help reduce that noise transmission. Then let's talk about moisture control. If your garage is really hot because it's summertime and your house is cooler because you have your AC running, if that common wall doesn't have some manner of barrier in it, those two temperatures meet in the construction of the wall, and that's how you end up with moisture and mildew and eventually mold growth that can happen. So you definitely want to create a barrier that's going to prevent any kind of mold, mildew, or condensation from forming in the wall. In my opinion, I've given you a lot of great reasons why you're going to want to insulate that garage common wall. If that's the case and you're ready to take the plunge, check out the dealer finder on our website. There you're going to find RetroFoam dealers across the country who can help you create a barrier to keep that gross garage smell, heat, cold, and whatever out of your house. I'm your building science brainiac, reminding you to bring a little science to every project.